Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. Last time, we played through Classic Mode using Link on Intensity 8 and did pretty damn good, I have to say that I'm not that good with Link. And this time, we're gonna be playing as Zelda and doing the exact same thing. So, starting off of course with palette swaps, we have regular Zelda. That one, it's kind of more red, a blue one. That looks kind of like a more classic Zelda, I think. The green dress. The Dark Zelda, which I think is really cool. Or is that more classic? I guess that's the more classic look. And then like a bridal outfit. So she's got some pretty cool palette swaps, but of course, going with the classic. And we're gonna go in at 8 because I'm definitely not going up to 9 with Zelda because I'm really bad with Zelda. Not only am I really bad with Zelda, she's also, I think she's 55th on the tier list out of 58 characters. So there's only 3 characters worse than her, like judging, the fans judged that there's only 3 characters worse than her, and I think it's like 2 of the Mii fighters and then 1 other character that I don't remember, so I think it's Ganondorf, Mii Sword Fighter, and Mii Gunner who are below Zelda, so yeah, she's not great, and I don't really know how to play her, as you can plainly see, because nothing's happening so far. Nothing good, anyway. We'll get into her special moves in a little bit. I don't really want to be trying to explain them in this, what is essentially going to be a one-on-two fight, because my teammate's not going to be doing too great. Oh, there's Midna now, so it's 1-on-3 now. Good! And my teammate's dead. It was caught. I didn't even notice who my teammate was. I wasn't paying attention to it. Is Midna? Yep, there's Midna. She got me. Alright, let's try this. Nope. Get down here. I'm just trying to keep my distance until we get some decent items, because this is not gonna go our way. Oh my god. Holy crap, they are... I've done, like, nothing to them. I haven't died yet, which is good. But I can see this kind of doing us in here. Oh, what? We got Robin with the beetle. And we got him out, okay. I'm surprised that worked. Ooh, hello. Final smash already? Yes, here we go. So this, if we can connect with it, is the light arrow. There we go. That's the whole final smash, but we got to show it off. So I'm okay with that. As long as you're on in a line, in a straight line with the other character, that light arrow is going to connect, and it's most likely going to kill. Because it does that. It's really powerful. All right. Yeah, DK, we can deal with DK, I think. Oh, giant Diddy Kong. With Donkey Kong and Bowser on our team. Okay. This'll be fun. Having the two heavyweights on our team. This'll be pretty interesting. Against Giant Diddy. Throwback to Subspace once again. I like how he's like barely bigger than like Bowser. Well, he's a bit bigger, but he doesn't look all that out of place right now. And he's gone already. Okay. Wow. I don't even know how he died. I think DK footstooled him or something? I don't know. That was weird, but we got it. That was easy. To be honest, the giant characters don't work too well on Jungle Japes, especially because, like, well, because they're so big. I think if they were to... Is that a Go-Goat trophy? If they were to, like, grab onto a ledge and hang off of it, I think their bottom half goes into the water and causes them to get swept away. I think. I feel like that's probably what just happened. Blue, green, or red. The harder the path, the better the reward. I know. And also WarioWare Incorporated yet again. I feel like we're here every episode. Then again, I did pick the Wario path, so that could be why. Let's throw this No, I want to use my beetle. I want to use my beetle. Go. Is that going to get anybody? Nope. No, you do. Oh, no. Okay, well, I guess let's try and show off some special moves here. Standard special is Nehru's Love. I'm almost dead. Is Nehru's Love, which is this. It does a little bit of damage, but I think it's mostly used for reflecting projectiles. Although I usually don't find all that much use for it. It's just not a move that I find myself using. I'll take this Gust Bellows real quick, though. Let's clear a bit. No! No! Okay. I'm just trying to clear at least one or two of these guys off of the stage. So that I can show off the rest of these. Alright, Wario's gone. Don't move. Oh god, that had already run out. Okay, well, at least we both move. Side special is Din's fire. You press and hold it, and then you can kind of influence its up and down direction, kind of. Oh my god, oh my god. I actually avoided that still. Wow. You can influence its up and down direction and kind of control when it explodes, which is pretty neat. The up special, which you've been seeing, is Feroz Wind. Once you activate that, you can kind of control which direction you go. If you do it in the air, for example, you can go straight down to the ground. If you want, thank you, Chespin. I knew that was going to happen, and Pit got the final smash. Oh, good. The second he uses this, we're dead. Three sacred treasures. Don't let this kill me. It's switching to the micro game incredibly slowly. Okay, we didn't die. I'm okay with that. I'm gonna jump though. Pit, you did this to yourself. Oh, he actually got out. Okay, well, he's gone now. Okay. And then we still need to show off the down special, which has changed, because if you remember when we played through Brawl, Sheik was the down special. You would use Transform. The down special was called Transform, and you would change into Sheik. But as I'm sure you've been able to see, Sheik is her own character. So the down special had to change because transformations in general were removed in this game. That's why Charizard was brought back and not the rest of the Pokemon trainer, and why Samus and Zero Suit Samus are different characters, etc., etc. So Zelda's new down special is the Phantom Slash. Press and hold it, and then out comes the Phantom. And it can take a couple hits, I think, before it gets destroyed, and the longer you hold it, the further out it goes. There you go, it can be kind of used to, just be used to protect yourself at the last minute, I guess. I never really found all that much use for it, it feels very situational. But it's of course based off of the Phantoms from, the DS Zelda games. Twilight Princess, Phantom Hourglass, and Spirit Tracks. I think it's just Phantom Hourglass, I'm not too sure though. So I guess that can be our comment question of the day, since we've started doing that now. Give me that. Okay, well, it's gone. What's your favorite Zelda DS game? I know last time we specifically spoke about, what's your favorite Zelda game, but on the DS, what would be your favorite? Because there's those two, and then is there any others on the DS that I'm not remembering? There's Tingle's Rosy Rupee Land, I'm going to include that on this. Let's say DS and 3DS. Like, give me your favorite DS Zelda game and your favorite 3DS Zelda game. Because I really haven't played that many, well, you know by now, I haven't played that much Zelda in general, but For example, I own Ocarina of Time 3D, I own Triforce Heroes, I don't own either of the DS ones. I'm trying to look over at my collection right now to see what I own. I have Hyrule Warriors Legends, on 3DS. So I have a few Zelda games on 3DS. I feel like, do I have Link Between Worlds? I might, I don't know, my collection's on the other side of my room, I can't quite tell right now, but... Oh, nice, he jumped into Boss Galaga. Bye, villager. This is going a little better than I was expecting it to, I'm not gonna lie. Like, this is going considerably better than I thought it would. I see Lego games, I see Luigi's Mansion. Yeah, I think I just have... I have Triforce Heroes, I have Ocarina of Time 3D, and I have Hyrule Warriors Legends. On 3DS. From the Zelda series. Yeah. I also have the original Hyrule Warriors on Wii U. Oh, Xerneas and Lugia! Well, I was actually gonna go for Xerneas because it was the red path, but oh well. I guess it didn't want me to do that. Wow, I have a lot of 3DS games. I'm just looking over at my shelves right now. I never really realized how many 3DS games I have that I just haven't played. It's... I have a lot of games that I haven't played. That's why Quick Play exists. Hello, Past Me, and I think that's Ronald? And also a Bellsprout? In here for some reason? There goes Ronald. We still have yet to see the Miis that Augusto sent me. They have not shown up yet. Did I just deck Ryan in the face with a football? I think it was Ryan. Fire flower. I really just want one of Augusto's Miis to show up because he took the time to send them to me and I scanned him in. I'm sure we'll get him eventually. We've got a bunch of characters still to play through as. Oh, there we go. And also, I need to make specific Mii fighters for when we play through as the Mii fighters, so... Maybe we'll make one of Augusto, because he sent me those. We shall see. Oh, I forgot I threw that. Get rid of you. I kind of screwed that up because of the blue shell, and now it's just Mii versus Mii. Hello, Mii. How's it going? Is that me? I think that's me. That's not me! It looked kinda like me. I don't actually remember who that is. I have a lot of people on my 3DS from when I used to be in a bunch of Smash Skype groups, but then Skype basically died, so I'm not in those groups anymore. Who uses Skype anymore? So, I have a lot of people on here that I don't remember. I feel like that guy's name is... I feel like that guy's name is Evan, but I'm not too sure. So I don't want to say for definite that it is. But hey, we've made it without having to use a continue yet. I mean, we've died. Have we died? Did we die yet? Yeah, Chesspin killed us. But we've made it here without having to use a continue, so there's a chance that we can beat this on 8.0 with Zelda. I don't want to jinx it, but we'll see. Shield through that, okay, nice. Zelda's forward and back airs are very powerful, and I could have probably reflected that. They're very powerful if you connect with them at like a certain time. As you can see, we just did like 4 or 5 of them, and it took out Master Hand, so... yeah, no bad. Not bad at all. Master Core, I am ready for you. Master Giant, that is. Up smash. I did that too early again. Okay. Hit him with one of those. And then get ready for the bombs. Oh, we got stuck in the ground. Oh, that actually worked out in our favor. Yeah, look at this. We should just hit him with these forward and back aerials. They're actually kind of ridiculously powerful. Look at that. Oh, and you feel the impact from them. Whew. Zelda, you're actually... you're fun to play as, I've got to say. Like, in single player. Like, playing as Zelda in multiplayer, I never really have all that much fun. But look at that, boom! When you can actually connect with that over and over again. I guess it's kind of like connecting with Captain Falcon's forward air. Like, it's kind of difficult to pull off in multiplayer, but in single player like this, you can do it over and over again, freeze the screen, and just kind of make everything feel great. Oh, it's so good, so satisfying to connect with that. You can kind of see it like flashes, and if you connect with the look at that! Zelda, you monster! Zelda is a freaking monster in single player! This is like using Charizard's friggin' rock smash in Brawl against all the bosses. Oh no. Oh, we perfect shielded that! I think that was a perfect shield. Can we reflect these? Oh, I think we also did damage to Master Edges with that. There we go. Aerial. Zelda, you are kicking ass right now. Zelda, you are kicking everybody's ass. Oh! I take back everything bad I've ever said about Zelda. Because I know I've said bad stuff about Zelda before. I've never really been a fan of her playstyle, but... oh my god, look at this. I know I'm just abusing the AI right now, and that's why I'm having fun with Zelda, but still. Oh my god. And to break the fourth wall, because I kind of want to do that right now, because I'm having such a good time and a good mood. The time I'm recording this, this is really breaking the fourth wall, in about 10 minutes, so once I finish this episode, I'm going out with my dad to go watch the new Star Wars movie, so, I'm very excited, so the fact that this ended up being a good run, I mean, we might die now, but the fact that most of this was a- you did not just spike me. There we go! And we're at exactly 100. The fact that this was a good run has put me in a good mood, and I'm excited to go see Star Wars. Now, I'm not excited that I appear to be dropping frames, because that would be a bad time if that were to happen. Is that happening? Did it come back? I think it's good. Alright, taunts. Up taunt. Side taunt. Down taunt. Yep. We just gotta say goodbye to this guy, because I've wasted a little bit of time just walking around right there, so... give it a couple more hits. I mean, we can still technically, we could avoid the... oh, I should do that. Because we're at 2 stocks. I should just let him do his thing. I should let him freak out, try and explode so we can try and avoid it. Let's do this. Nope. I can't get the timing right on that. God damn it, Master Core, get out of here. That looked badass as hell. Zelda, that looked badass. Just kicked him out of that. Holy crap. That was fun. I had a lot of fun with that run. Holy crap. And we got Linebeck and Thanatos. I love these two. Well, I can officially say that's the most fun I've had with a run in quite a while. I mean, I've had fun with runs, don't get me wrong. But that was just joy the whole way through. Even that first match with our terrible teammate Corin. Like, as bad as that ended up being, we still managed to do it without having to use a continue. We just beat this on 8 with Zelda, which I never thought I would do. I'll be honest, I thought this was going to be an awful run. But it wasn't. And, we got to kill Master Corin in a really cool way, so I can't complain. I cannot complain. And this looks like it's going to be a pretty, pretty artsy background image right here. Pretty artsy-fartsy. Looks like it's the Edgelord version of Zelda. Looking off into the distance, looking off over... Kind of like, it kind of reminds me of the cliff from Brawl. You know the cliff, the Brawl cliff. Kind of reminds me of the Brawl cliff. Right, here we go. Almost done. We got this, Zelda. You're kind of kicking a lot of ass, even in the credits. You have been doing the finest of work, my friend. My friend Zelda. I do kind of wish that she had some different costumes other than the palette swap she has, like... Well, actually, no. I think one of them is based off of a Skyward Sword appearance. Like, the colors, at least. But it's not, like, an actual direct costume. I kind of wish you could have the different Links and the different Zeldas as costumes. I think that'd be pretty neat. You know, like, have... Because Twilight Princess Zelda looks incredibly different from Skyward Sword Zelda, but imagine if you could have both of them. But the... Obviously, just keep the trophy the same. Just keep it the Twilight Princess trophy, but... You know, just have the different designs. I think that'd be really neat, but... I can see why they did it. Plus, with Link, he had some really cool palette swaps. You know, with Dark Link. Official Dark Link, not just like a shadow version. And Fierce Deity and stuff like that. I think that he got some really neat costumes. Alright, here we go. Satoru Iwata, rest in peace, my friend! Sora, you... God damn it, Sora. I love how you could hear why was there a crowd, but you could hear the crowd go, whoa, as she went off the side. I've never heard that in the credits before. That's so strange. Why would there be a crowd watching her do the credits game? Anyway, bye, fighter. Let's find Zelda. There she is. This is the namesake of the Legend of Zelda games. Her appearance may change, but she always plays an important role. In Smash Bros, she's quick on the draw when it comes to magic, though a bit slow when moving. She has a new move that summons a phantom to her aid. That seems like a really, like, not that descriptive, description. But hey, it's a cool looking trophy. I like the detail. I love the Twilight Princess designs. And I love that they basically made a Twilight Princess design for Sheik. Like, that's pretty neat, even though Sheik wasn't in Twilight Princess. Anyway, with that, folks, that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. Of course, next time we're taking on Classic Mode with Sheik. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then. Don't forget to answer the comment question, too. See you guys then.